What up, YouTube? Wag 100 speaks on YSL and Lil Woody once again cooperating with the feds. He also speaks on Lil Wayne tour bus getting shot up and says the gentleman that was responsible for that did his time and did not get locked up for that. Speaks on the charges laid out before Young Thug. They also speak on Young Thug pretty much being over. The case is done. And if he gets offered 20 years, he better take it. It's an interesting conversation. I'm gonna let y'all get to it, man. Shout out to Wag 100. Shout out to Clout Monsters. This is Getty Radio. Let's go.
Hey, Wag, did they already touch that shit in y'all room about the dude Woody and YSL? Y'all already touched on that?
The nigga telling?
Yeah,
but nah, y'all, because when I said it months ago, y'all kept saying, oh, Wag, there you go with your negative shit, because it's solid. I said, them young niggas ain't been laced with this shit. Half of them 25, 24 years old. When they get up in that mother, for one, somebody already telling. You seen they said the nigga was wearing a wire already.
Right.
It was already, I said, bro.
He telling back 2015.
Somebody was working with him to get him the information. Out of 28 people, at least 15 gonna tell for sure.
Yeah, and for that, and for them to be on them fools as long as they was, this shit is only gonna get bigger. This is only gonna get worse for a lot of them. Cause I for them to be
watch when
on
they
that
bring
long.
In the other two crews.
Yeah, cause she's oh girl, I forget her name, but what is she? The DA? She says she is not done.
Hey, Wack, I think the only way that could save Young Thug is for him to bring a bigger name. Do you think he would Lil even Baby. Think or have the thought of mentioning Baby's name?
Nah, bro, what y'all talking about? Y'all talking crazy right
now. Nah, I'm saying, what I'm saying is that they've been investigating a man for 10, 12 years. You don't think there's one
Lil Baby
call,
only been
one...
on for four, bro.
Who?
Lil Baby only
Lil Baby. I'm talking about Young Thug, my fault. Yeah, switch it up.
Yeah, Lil Baby only been in the, you know, he been running around the music industry till like 2018, bro. I can't, you know.
Oh yeah, rappers on here, watch out.
Lil Baby got a good team.
Not Lil Baby, I was talking about Baby, like Birdman, you feel me? I'm talking about Young Thug and Birdman, not Lil Baby.
I thought he's playing with them like that.
What about Birdman?
I don't know. I'm saying like that's the only bigger name he could bring up to try to get himself up out of it.
Yeah, but the bigger name got to have something to do with it.
For music, bro, he ain't, I don't know.
Stunner
ain't using no rap to do no gangster shit if that's what he doing. Believe that. Ain't happening. That was from New Orleans, my nigga. He ain't doing that. That nigga from New Orleans is a millionaire down there hungry for nothing. He not using no rap to do nothing gangster. Them niggas did music together. They got money together, that type of shit. He ain't did nothing crazy.
Sorry, I got one more question for you then, Wack, right?
Because hey,
you
know chill,
the nigga who shot at Lil Wayne's.
Names, bro.
The one who shot at Lil Wayne's, when Lil Wayne's bus was linked to YSL, was linked to Young Thug. And then after that whole situation with the bus getting shot up.
Never went to jail for that.
Who, Roscoe?
Roscoe went to jail. What he went to jail did his 5 years and came home.
But in the indictment is saying that he was linked to the bus getting shot up in an indictment in the 60-page indictment.
He went to jail for that.
You saying? I hear what you're saying. Say that.
He never went to jail for that, bro.
Yeah,
he's in there right now. If you look at his indictments, he got drugs, possession of a firearm, and something else. His little three charges.
Hey, when I seen that, hold on, man.
They got everybody charges up, and his charges ain't got nothing to do with none of that.
Yeah. Now, that one video about that Woody, when we was listening to it in here the other day, man, after I seen that clip and what he's saying and all the statements he wrote, and that shit was looking scary for Young Thug.
I told all y'all, I said, bro, Thug is John Gotti in this situation. He's a top. Everything that happened underneath, they gonna squeeze the niggas closer to him and they gonna tell.
Hey, man, it wasn't hard to tell that these guys were going to snitch if you ever read that indictment. I've read it. I have the indictment. It is full of mess, but Young Thug don't have a lot of charges on there. But if you look at the other people that have most of the charges, you know someone is going to talk. And that someone was a very important person involved in the situation. And that person was Lil Woody, right? So WAC 100 was right about this. He did call it. A lot of people said that those guys were going to stand solid. As we see, that it's not happening. The case is falling apart for Young Thug. And Young Thug is pretty much in a position where he can't snitch or he's got to deliver a big fish. Y'all let me know what he's going to do in the comment section. Let's get back to it.
Then told on the body. He told, I was there when he rented the car. I was there when he met the guys. I was there when the call came.
God damn.
He told all that shit. I said, yo, bro, them little niggas, he 25. They set him in front and said, you looking at 25. What you want to do? And Lord forbid, they press play and let him hear Thug saying, oh, man, fuck that nigga, man. I ain't, you know.
Man, or just some shit.
That's what they do.
Yeah. Over with. They do that with a girl and everything. Look, he talking to the other girl.
Yeah.
He said he love her. He don't love you.
He hear any of that type of shit. Them little niggas fall for it and there it go.
Here's what I trip off of. In the 90s, it was the street sitting on top with the rap sitting beneath them. And I'm pretty much not even involved, just making music. Mm-hmm. It seemed like that's done flip-flop, whereas the rap got the street niggas under them. That's what's crazy.
Because it ain't no more 90s money. It is rap money.
Right. Yeah. So damn.
That's what's going on with that.
Jeez, I'm thinking like 20. If they offer him 20, he better sign that shit.
Y'all told me bullshit. Y'all put it.
Hold on, bro.
Y'all was like, nah, Black Joe. What you mean? It's just a state RICO. I say, bro, state feds. I got niggas that got 120 years for the state case.
That's a fact.
Ain't no time restriction because it's state. It's just a percentage of the time you got to do on the time.
They throw them calendars at you quick, boy.
The worst part about Thug is he's the first one for this DA, and she try to make an example.
No, you can leave the word trying out. She going to make an example. That word trying gone.
Done made an example.
Yeah, she making examples.
Yeah, she's serious as shit.
She's not done.
She's making a name for herself right now.
She's trying to get the show.
She gonna run for something. As soon as this case is over.
That Woody dude. That Woody dude been snitching hard.
The VP of the United States of America was the district attorney of San Francisco and got a rep from giving niggas 20 and 30 and 40 years for marijuana charges. Old girl is looking at that and she's trying to mimic that, bro.
Mm-hmm. That's a fact. There you go.
And she's from Cali.
Oh, is she?
Facts. What? No, we was just talking about this show on the music channel the other day.
Yeah, the VP of the United States of America. She was the district attorney of San Francisco in the Bay. She got known for giving niggas 20, 30, and 40 years for weed.
Yeah, but see, people outside of the Bay, and especially outside of Cali, don't know Kamala was like that.
Yeah,
they don't
that's
know
where she got her rep from. So now you got a Black DA. That's what
she was sucking old boy off. Don't forget the dude that she was sucking off.
Willie Brown. Yeah.
Look, you got a Black DA from Cali in Atlanta. She ain't got no roots to nothing in Atlanta. Knowing that this Black DA, from doing what she did, got became recognition VP, to go over there and run for president, become the VP of the United States. She going for what she knows. She trying to fall right in the footsteps.
They are locking up artists left and right over lyrics. You hear me? That shit's fucking insane right now. It's changed from drug laws because we done legalized that shit in so many places to this shit now. So
some of these cats are snitching on themselves in their own songs. They actually dropping details.
Hell yeah.
That's how you get indicted.
Yeah, that shit's wild. Like, why are you writing that down?
I don't know. I was watching some
Matt Dre. Matt Dre did 5 years in the shoe behind that shit. Behind lyrics.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he did. He talked about a bank robbery. He had details that they said was only known by the people that was involved. Yup, look that shit up. He did 5 years in the shoe behind
that. Was the first two rappers to get indicted for
X-rated too. X-rated too, you right? From Sacramento.
We gonna leave it right here, man. Listen, self-snitching is a big thing today. What do y'all think about this YSL case? Do you think that this woman is shooting for her presidential shot by going hard at rappers like Kamala Harris did out in Sacramento, California, man? She was hard on the brothers out there. She was hard on crime, or tough on crime, as they say. Do you think that this woman, the DA down there in Georgia, is doing the same thing? Do you think she's taking this tough on crime approach? And if she is, that means it is the end of YSL, and Young Thug probably won't see the light of day for another 20 years. And you also have to take into account what they spoke about earlier in the video, the other two gangs that they're possibly going to be rounding up in the future. Are they going to be rappers? Are they going to be celebrities? Is Lil Baby going to get caught up in this like a lot of people are speculating? A lot of their enemies, are they going to get caught up in RICOs like they're speculating, right? This is a convoluted case, but it's a dark end for a lot of people, and somebody's going to get some serious time behind this, and somebody's going to be known forever as a snitch. Anyway, that's my video. This has been Getty Radio. I appreciate you being here. Please like, comment, subscribe. I will catch you guys on the flip side. Peace.